All right. And now for the message of God's word, here is Brother Calvin. Put your hands together for Brother Calvin.
Amen, amen. Good night, everyone. I must say it is a great privilege, honor, for me to stand here tonight and read something from the Word of God and try to explain it to the best of my knowledge. Amen. First of all, I have an announcement to make. The announcement goes like this. It comes from the ICU unit in hell. Satan isn't doing so well. And I'm fear he's going to be dead after tonight. Amen. So, anyhow, I have a message here tonight that I was asked to share. But first of all, you know, the Lord wants us to do three things. Tonight he wants us to rejoice. He doesn't want us to worry. And he wants to give us his peace, ultimate peace. Amen. Anybody ready to receive those three things? Amen. But first of all, I want to give a little word of encouragement before I start. Do not let anything in this world disrupt your Christian walk. You see, because our God is a jealous God, you know. Anybody know that? That God is a jealous God. The God that we serve is a jealous God. So if you put your money in front of God, he go take it. Only believe that. If only love only children before God, what you go do? You go take it. If only love only wife before God and husband, guess what? He go take that. So hear what? Love God first. Anyhow, let me turn to Philippians chapter 4. And we're going to read from 4 to 7. Amen. It goes, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God which passeth all understanding should keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. So tonight, you see, first, we want to rejoice in spite of everything that is going on in and around us. In any circumstance in life, you know, last week we hear 50,000 people in City Corp going and get off. Anybody hear that? 50,000 people. Just imagine, we have 52 states in America. That is going to affect every little community somehow or the other. If you picture 1,000 families from the Van Wyck to Woodhaven Boulevard, I don't think it have 1,000 houses on 101 Avenue. So imagine all these houses in foreclosure. Only thing that is not a pretty sight, not so. Not so at all. So you see, we had to rejoice in all circumstances. You see, because we are in the hands of a wise, loving God. Amen? One who always works to accomplish good things for us so that we could always rejoice. Isn't that good? Isn't that comforting to know that in any circumstances, our God is coming true for us? Amen. And here, in verse 6, it says, be careful for nothing. This means don't worry. Don't worry about anything. It doesn't mean to disregard, you know, legitimate concerns, but overall, don't worry about nothing, because in any matter of life, the way to be free from anxiety is to be prayerful. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. So you see, we could take everything that bothering we in prayer to God and not worry about it. Because you see, he say, here, anxiety is to be prayerful. You have to be prayerful in order to resolve your anxiety. You see, God is eager to hear our requests. And when we pray, we must pray with a heart of thanksgiving. Not only, you know, just ask God for what you want, but be thankful for what you have. You understand? So, you see, God want to give us something else too. He want to give us peace. And this is not just a piece of cake or a piece of something. You know. This is a peace that passeth all understanding. So, we can buy this. We could only get this from God. You know, and I want to thank God for taking me out from, you know, the gutter. You know, from a gutter rat and making me an aristocrat. How I look tonight? Huh? I look good, eh? I look normally. You don't see me tie and thing, eh? Amen, amen. You see? Boy, I tell you, like, one of my friends, I was telling Pastor, I could share something with you while I was saying it here. One of my friends called me last week, Sunday morning, when I was in church. He said, boy, call where you? Five times I sat down, and the phone ring five when I go outside after service. He said, where you? I said, boy, you only know a day in church, but he said, no wonder, boy, with this thing going on, the economy so bad, look where you there. You understand? Well, that isn't all he said, but I can't say that here. But anyway, you see, the peace God wants to give me is an inner tranquility. You understand? This he wants to give to each and every believer so that we could be free from worry and doubt and disbelief. He wants to give away a peace that passeth all understanding. The divine peace to bestow upon us in times of worry, so wonderful that it exceeds our ability to comprehend. God wants to give you a kind of peace that we don't understand, that when we in situation, that peace he will give will drown out any situation that we in. Who want to receive that kind of peace tonight? Well, let me tell you something. If all you want to experience that kind of peace, all you have to accept Christ in our heart. Because first you had to be called a child of the King. To be qualified for that type of peace. Amen. So, you know, sometimes when things come in we way and we don't understand it, the Bible say here to pray. That is what it say here, to pray. Bring everything, not a few things, but everything to God in prayer. You know, when a lot of people who just get sick and worried and stressed out is because I believe if I that type of person is worried real bad. Any little thing when I hear 50,000, that 50,000 people gonna get off. I study in that whole day. I study in what going on with these people family, because let me tell you, when money in my bank going on a little bit, I just get worried. So when I read after today, I read this, I tell you, let me tell you something. I ain't worrying at all. You understand? Because if the word of God says so, it's so. And if the word of God says so, it's so, and I believe it so. Yes. And that settles it. Yes, anyhow, so I want to encourage everybody to, you know, this Christian walk is, I think, like Pastor said this morning, narrows the way to salvation and, you know, broad is the way to destruction. But I want to encourage everybody to keep walking the walk. You know, and press forward until the day we see the King. Amen. Amen.